Hello, welcome to this new video. On the left we have a C# 9.NET 5 app running in Visual Studio 2019. On the right we have a C# 10.NET 6 app running in Visual Studio 2022. In this video I'm going to go over three new things that the thing on the right can do, but the thing on the left can't. First up are improvements to string interpolation. So if you wanted to declare a constant string here called action, which was subscribe, obviously, and we had a static string message here, which looked a little bit like this, don't forget to action, and then we did a console.WriteLine message. In C# 9.NET 5, this would obviously say don't forget to subscribe. That's pretty cool. However, if we wanted to prevent after setting this message something like this happening, like if we can run the app and change the entire message to like or whatever we wanted, if we wanted to stop this from being possible, a sensible way of doing it is a private setter or something like this. But here, we want to try set this to a constant, but C# 9 won't let us do this. What we want to be able to do is make sure that this can't change at runtime. If we port our code over to C# 10 over here, like so, do our message here, like, bung that in there. These guys need to go in the class, not the namespace. Right, so here we've ported it over, and now in C# 10 we can change this to const, which is great because this prevents us changing the message to like. Fantastic. That's something you can do in C# 10, but not C# 9. See, doesn't work. Very cool. Next up are improvements to records. For example, if we had a record type which was a person, public record person, took a first name and a last name, we can do something like this. Barry steak fries, like this, see? Fries, and then print it out. Whoop. And that will use the built-in ToString representation, which looks a little bit like this. Now, if you wanted to customize that ToString and override the formatting of it, we would do an override string ToString, like share. And instead of returning the base, we would return something like this, first name, last name. Steak fries, which is pretty cool. So far, so C# 9. Imagine we want to be able to prevent the ability to do this, always Gary person. So we need to override the constructor there. Now, if we wanted to do this, override string to string, no matter what the name of the person, it's always going to be Gary. Now if we make this an always Gary person and run the app, it always returns Gary no matter the name that we've provided. Now if this was a normal object, you would be able to seal this to prevent this from happening. However, in C# 9 you cannot seal the ToString version, the ToString override on a record. No prizes for guessing that you can do this in C# 10. So if you move all of this over to our C# 10 app, over here, our always Gary person will say Gary. Now if we wanted to prevent always Gary person from being able to override the string representation of the person, we can just do sealed, and now This is prevented from happening. You literally can't write the code to do it. Cannot override inherited member person.toString because it isn't sealed. There you go. Sorry, Gary. Last but not least, our improvements to deconstructors of records. So if we have a simple person record here, we can create a new person. Then and just again we'll use old Barry here. If we wanted to deconstruct this into two new variables, we can, like so, and run that. Barry Steak Fries gets written on two lines. So we've created a person record and deconstructed it into first and last. So far, so useful. However, what if, and obviously for a more complicated sample, we wanted to actually declare this earlier. So if var first was actually at this point Gary, and we wanted to then override it here with Barry from person, C-sharp 9 does not let you do this. No prizes for guessing that C-sharp 10 does. Need to move the record over, obviously. Record, there you go. You can see here on the right that you can deconstruct Barry Steak Fries here into this first variable, overriding Gary, and the Steak Fries into a new variable last in the same method. And this is not possible in C-sharp 9. There you go. This will be correctly Barry Steak Fries in C-sharp 10. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching this little demo. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos along these lines. Cheers.